So I want to add this.
With thousands of beads to choose from, Teresa Cline selects an array for a necklace she's creating.
Jewelry just seems to create happy for people. Just having a lot of fun with it, making lots of necklaces.
But for her, making jewelry isn't just about having nice pieces to wear or give as gifts. For her, the value of these necklaces, made bead by bead, runs much deeper. These are necklaces for Nicaragua.
The class is a huge success.
Cline recently returned from a trip to the garbage dump community of El Limonal in Nicaragua, where she and a team of other humanitarians worked to deliver food hampers and support housing projects. But during the trip, Cline also hosted a jewelry making workshop for people in the community.
I had these three little kits and I was expecting maybe 3 to 6 people, and I was going to teach them how to make the necklace like I make, and had it all worked out. Everyone showed up. I stepped back and there was probably 15 to 20 people in that room. And a big suitcase full of beads, and then I opened up all the stuff and put it out. They were creating all sorts of cool necklaces all on their own and so excited about all their different creations, so that they made necklaces for their babies, their husbands, themselves. It was pretty amazing to watch because these people live in poverty. So it was so nice to be able to give them a little piece of happy in their daily struggle of a life.
Struggles and hardships that, for a moment, these people were able to forget about, consumed by the joy of creating jewelry.
When I went there teaching the class, I was thinking, oh, these people are in survival mode. I'm going to teach them how to make jewelry. It'll get them out of the dump, which is a dangerous place to be, and they'll start making jewelry and sell it, and maybe I can, you know, start a new business for them. But what surprised me is they didn't actually want to learn how to do a business. They wanted it for themselves because it's not something they get. So I think a lot of people that live in poverty, they actually want the luxury items that we take for granted.
Cline documented the workshop for her YouTube channel, Teresa the Traveler, a scrapbook of the countless trips around the world she's taken, all with her camera in hand to capture the action.
Right now we're going through the market of the old village.
I was just kind of doing it to share with my friends and family what it was like, because it's hard to describe the experiences. And then I just ended up with YouTube channel, and I mean, I love technology in that it allows me to give a first-hand look at the places that I've been to and the people I've met to my friends and family via YouTube, and all I need is my little camera with the selfie stick.
It was pretty amazing.
Armed with her simple little camera, Cline is able to bring a taste of her travels to people back home in Kamloops and all over the world. In this case, people who donated jewelry to her cause were able to see it paid forward on the people in Nicaragua.
I just started noticing pieces that I recognized being donated on, like, different kids and different, you know, elderly ladies. Like, everyone was wearing jewelry, and I recognized so much of it as donations, so I started taking video and pictures and posting it on Facebook of all these favorite pieces that people were wearing, so that people could actually see their donation on someone, something that, you know, we don't even wear anymore, we're not using, and it gets shipped across the world and it creates so much joy for some people.
Oh, let's see. Oh, very pretty. Very